Hello everyone, my name is Robert Byssz, and in this short video I'm going to share with you some of my learnings about startup sales and how it compares to sales that we do normally in corporations. And in the second part of the video, I'm bringing you some of the hints that I gathered in my experience, the first few steps that I believe you should start doing right away if you want to start your startup. There are so many people around the globe sitting at their desk in their large corporation, dreaming about starting their own startup with some of their friends. I have seen some great successes and I have seen some great failures. In today's video, I want to start from comparing the two worlds and how corporate sales differs from startup sales. So on one hand, in traditional sales, you have the brand, you have the brand promise and the huge brand value behind you, and you have to sell those and the products offered by that company or solutions. In the startup world, you have none of these. Your brand value is zero and your brand is not known by anyone. So let's face it, in startup sales, you have nothing that you were educated on. You cannot build on the brand that is behind you. The customers will not believe in the brand, the customers will believe in you and only in you. The second difference that you want to keep in mind is that in the corporate sales, you are getting leads delivered to your mailbox in most of the cases. In case of startup sales, nobody is delivering you leads. You will have to build and generate your own leads right from the start. In traditional sales or corporate sales, somebody has already done the homework for you. Somebody has mapped out the customer pains, the desires of the customers. They have made the market validation and even they made some decisions about market entry. All of this will have to be done by you in a startup, and it has to be done in a very agile way, which is most likely not the way how your corporation was doing it. At a traditional organization where many of us have experience, what you have to do is you just have to prove that the new product that you are offering is actually up to the standards, what the customers got used to. In case of startup, it's completely different. You have to prove that you are not a scam. You are not just a new bunch of friends who decided to leave their job and kick off their own startup. So when it comes to how to start a startup, you will find a new method on every corner. They will tell you how to write your beautiful canvases and how to design your company. The only thing that I haven't seen too often taught is that B2B sales is super hard if you want to do it in a startup. I personally love to call it lean B2B sales, which stands for lean business-to-business sales. The reason for that is lean, by definition, is driving you to experiment before you would invest too much time or too much energy into any of your projects. So as a start, I would like to give you my first three hints that I always give to new startupers when they start their journey. So the very first one is, I always encourage everyone to go out on the market and test their ideas. I ask you, don't spend ages on designing your lean canvas, business model canvas, or whatsoever method you are believing in. I would love you to go out on the market and test the idea as soon as you guys believe in it. But always remember, don't sell just yet. You are just going out on the market so you can test your idea. I speak about some very basic and cheap stuff. I speak about a landing page, some content that will already generate some interest for you, and then some call to action at the very bottom of the page. So you can start to engage with your potential audience, you can start to gather that data, and you can set up some initial market validation interviews with them. My advice here is to not to overinvest into technology and not to try to automate everything from the very first minute. I rather would ask you to do everything by hand. Gather the data, gather the email addresses, and then speak with your customers, because this is how you are going to learn the most from them. Now, at the end of the first step, you have gathered some email addresses, some phone numbers about people who find your idea interesting enough so they are ready to speak with you. So this is where the fun starts. This is the second step. This is where you start to pick up the phone, you start to set up some customer interviews, and this is where you go out and you start to speak with live customers. What you want to achieve here is that at the end of the first step, or when you were ideating with your friends, with your colleagues from your startup, you guys believed that this can serve so many customers and you can help in so many segments. I want you to achieve a level where by this step, after the customer interviews, by the market validation, you see the two, maximum three customer segments where you can have the most and where you can gain the most. I just cannot remind you plenty enough that you are not selling here. Don't tell them how you're going to change the world and how you're going to be the best and why they should buy your idea. You are here to learn from them. And once you gathered from them what problems they have and what potential pains you can solve for them, then the next work that you have to do is to create your own Pareto. You have to find 80% of your potential gain in not more than 20% of your segment. So I really want you to come down to identify your very first segment that you are going to focus on. So now, at the end of the second step, you have your key customer segment. This is the one where you are giving the biggest business benefit for your customer. And in this segment, once you identified it, the third step kicks in. And the third step is actually about prospecting. I want to make sure that you guys are not aiming to have one or two business contacts. I want you to list everyone in the industry who can potentially benefit from your solution. And I suggest you start prospecting all of them. Don't just stop at one or two, go for the whole market. So when you start prospecting the whole industry, what you will find is to finding your first customer and your second customer who are going to be your first white paper and your second success story is going to be much easier. So my advice is start prospecting big time. I do not promise that this is going to be easy. None of these steps is easy. It's going to be hard. It's going to be hard work. And first and foremost, it's going to be hard because it's completely different than what the corporate sales or marketing methodologies we're educating you on. As I promised to you, it might not be fun, but it's going to bring you super fast idea validation, and you will know right from the start that you are on the right track. So just a quick recap. In the first step, I suggested you to gather your idea and instead of designing your startup to be the perfect startup, rather go out on the market as fast as possible and validate your idea. Once you have validated, I suggested you the second step to be go on market validation course, go and meet with the customers and make sure that you don't have more than two or three segments. It's not because you want to prospect all of them, but because you want to understand where you have your own Pareto, where you find 80% of the benefit that you can bring to your customers. Because once you have done this, you managed to get to point number three, which was go out on the market and start prospecting the whole market, because you want to have your first and your second customer success stories as soon as possible. My final advice is, when you're going out and you want to prospect on the market, I suggest you combining the best of the two words, sales and marketing. You might find it under the brand SMarketing, but what I'm just suggesting you is combining the old school cold calling with some of the coolest digital technologies available out there. If you combine this, then you will reach every potential customer you want to speak with. I promise you that. I really want to support you on your journey. So for that reason, I have worked out two exercises, which I usually do with the startups who I mentor. The first exercise, exercise A on this page, is designed for the very early stage startups who are just at the stage where they want to validate their ideas. On the document that you can download from here, you will have clear guidelines on how to design your first firmography and your first persona so you can start the market validation. Now, exercise B on this page is actually designed for those startups who already have done their market validation and they know that they have to scale, they need to prospect much better than how they do it today. So I'm sharing here on this page with you exercise B, which is again a clear instruction on how you can scale up your prospecting and do it in a more professional way. I hope that in today's video, I managed to share with you some of my insights about corporate sales versus startup sales and give you some hints how you can start your journey. Now, at the closing, what should I say? This is going to be a journey, and the only thing I wish you is you should make sure that you are going to enjoy this journey. It's going to be fun.